In today's video, I'm going to be quickly showing you how to access and join the Home Assistant beta. Now, this will work for whatever the current release is, as well as any other future release. Check it out.
If it's software, he knows it. If it's techie, he'll show it. If it's something fancier, something janky, it's MarkWattTech. You can automate it and try not to break it. It's MarkWattTech.
What's going on, guys? I hope you're all doing well. If you're watching this video, I'm going to be assuming that you're interested in checking out and joining the beta. So whether that's just to test a new feature or a particular new integration, or maybe you're just one of those awesome community people that want a head start and just checking out and testing things to make sure everything runs smoothly for the new release. Whatever your reason is, this video will have you covered. But before we get on to joining the beta, there's a couple of things that I just want to point out just to highlight what the beta is and what it isn't. So to start with, it is a beta, meaning it's an early release, so you should expect some bugs and also some changes. So don't go into this expecting this to be the final version and expect there to be no issues. The whole point of the beta is to just run through a round of testing and get things checked and fixed before the live version hits. If you're not aware of the stable and the beta release cycle for Home Assistant, then the stable version releases on the first Wednesday of every month and the beta starts on the last Wednesday of every month. So for example, at the time of recording this, it's currently October, so the last Wednesday in October will be the start of the beta for the November release, which will be the first Wednesday in November. Makes sense, right? The next thing I want to point out again comes back to the fact that this is a beta, so I wouldn't recommend installing this on your live instance of Home Assistant, just in case you do encounter any issues or bugs. The last thing you want is to lose access to various devices or all of them if your smart home goes down. And the other thing you really don't want is to feel the wrath of a disapproving wife that can no longer turn on the lights. Now, your whole Home Assistant totally dying is obviously the worst case scenario, but there are a couple of things that you can do to mitigate this and actually recover should this catastrophic incident actually occur. And when I say can do, what I actually mean is you should definitely do. So if you are installing the beta, then you should definitely be doing these things. I'd say that there's two main things that you need to do when you actually check out the beta. The first one is to actually read through the release notes. Just like with the stable release, reading through the release notes is going to save you a lot of time and a lot of headaches. You're going to be able to easily identify all the new features and changes, and you're also going to be able to see all the breaking changes. So do yourself a favor and save yourself some time and just have a careful read through the new features and changes, and in particular, the breaking changes. Now, you're not going to need to read through every single one, as you should be able to spot some of the ones that will affect you. So for example, there's a breaking change here for the Amazon Echo and Google Assistant. So if you use those services, then you might want to check that one out. The next thing that you should definitely be doing before joining the beta is ensuring you've got an up-to-date backup of your current Home Assistant instance. Now, there's a couple of different ways of doing this. My preferred method is using the Home Assistant Google Drive backup. Now, if you're not sure what that is or how you go about setting it up, I have done a little handy video that you can go and check that out if you want to set up the Google Drive backup. You can also make use of the inbuilt Home Assistant backups. So to do this, all you're going to do is just head down into your Supervisor tab, and then up at the top, you're going to choose Backups. From within here, you're going to press this blue button in the bottom right corner that just says Create Backup. Once you've clicked that, you're going to be asked to name the backup, so give it some kind of meaningful name to you, and then you're also going to need to set the backup type. With the backup type, you've got two different choices. You've got the full backup or a partial backup. The full backup is going to contain everything within your Home Assistant instance, and the partial backup is going to allow you to choose individual bits of Home Assistant that you want to back up. As an optional security layer, you can also add password protection. This is going to add a password to the file that's created, and you're going to need this password in order to unlock the backup. Once you're happy with your selections, you can go ahead and click Create. It will then just take a couple of minutes to actually create the backup, and depending on the options you went for, will determine the length of time it takes to actually create the backup. Once that's completed, you'll see it appear in this list here with the name that you gave it. You can then select it, and you can choose the three dots, and you can optionally download that then. So you could download this and save it on your desktop or to your NAS or somewhere else safe. As I previously mentioned, ideally you don't want to be running this on your live instance, but you can do it, and if you do have that backup, you do have a bit of a safety net, as if you install the beta and it just doesn't work for you or everything breaks, then you can just roll back to that backup. And I know not everyone has extra bits of hardware just lying around that you can just dedicate to a beta build of Home Assistant, but if you're after a really simple way of actually doing it, then you should check out setting up a virtual machine to actually run Home Assistant on. You could very easily and quickly spin up a virtual machine just to run the Home Assistant beta on. And over on the Home Assistant webpage, there's a great set of guides for various different virtual machines. So if you're interested in doing that, then go and check those guides out. They'll be linked in the description below. Equally, if you're interested in seeing me do a guide on how to actually set up one of these virtual machines, then let me know in the comments below. So So you've read the release notes, you've done your backups, and now you're ready to install the beta on your live instance, your virtual machine, or some other bit of hardware. Let's have a look at how we join the beta then. We're going to head over to our Home Assistant dashboard, and from here we're going to want to choose Supervisor. Up at the top, we're then going to want to choose System. From here, you'll notice the three cards at the top for Core, Supervisor, and Host. Inside of the Supervisor card, you'll see this option here to join the beta channel. So we're just going to go ahead and click that. You'll then get this final warning before joining the beta, which just reinforces the things that we spoke about. So it's a beta and it can contain unstable code, and you should make sure you've got the backups. As we've done that and we're happy, we're just going to go ahead and click Join Beta Channel. As soon as you do that, you'll see you get two new options. So there's now a newer version of the Supervisor available. So we've got an update button, and then we've also got the option to leave the beta channel. So let's go ahead and press update, and then we're just going to confirm that update. With that completed, you should see that the Supervisor is now the latest version and that little update button's gone. Then over on the left there in Core, we can see that there's now a new version of Core available. And if we look at that version number, we can see that it's the 2021.11 beta. And we've got a little update button next to that. So again, we're just going to go ahead and click update there. And again, we're just going to give that a couple of minutes to update and do its thing. After a few minutes, Core should fully update and you'll see the page refresh. And once that happens, you'll notice there that the newest version is that latest beta version. So congratulations, you're now part of the beta. Whilst you're playing around with the new features or just testing the beta in general, if you do come across any issues, then you should definitely report them on the Home Assistant GitHub. This is going to help yourself and also all the other Home Assistant users. With reporting issues, there's four main sections for issues. You've got core related issues, you've got issues with the front end, you've got issues with the supervisor, and issues with the documentation. Make sure that you're submitting your issue to the relevant section, and also be sure to include the beta version number in your issue's description. And if you're not sure on any of those things, just ask. Issues that are introduced in the beta are going to be worked on as a priority, so make sure that the thing that you're reporting is an actual issue and it's not just a feature request. I'll have a link to the Home Assistant beta release notes in the description below, so if you've got the time and there happens to be a new feature or a new integration, you now know how to beta, so go ahead and check it out and be sure to report any issues that you find. And there we go, that's how we set up the Home Assistant beta. If you've enjoyed this video, don't forget to drop me a like, and if you're not already, hit that subscribe button and ding dong the notification bell. You'll then be alerted to any future video that I do. As always, a massive thank you to these awesome dudes. These awesome dudes are my Patreons. If you're interested in supporting my channel and becoming one of these awesome dudes, then there'll be a link to my Patreon in the description below. So thank you for watching. I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.
So thank you for watching. And if you like the show, please hit that subscribe button. It's just down below. Go check out my videos. And don't you forget, for smart home software, automation, and more, it's MarkWattTech.